This boat has an outboard capable of mechanically shifting into forward, reverse, or neutral. This is how it looks in neutral, and this is how it looks while shifting. The output prop shaft relies on the red pins connecting with the green gear holes in order to start rotating. Here it is shifted into forward, the prop starts to turn clockwise. And now it is shifted into reverse, and you can see the prop rotational direction change. It's now turning counterclockwise. On the bench, the first problem arises. Because there is a rigid servo link connection, binding can happen. And in this case, the entire outboard flexes when the pins don't line up just right. A future revision should probably use springs in the linkage to reduce the binding. Once powered on, the binding issue all but goes away, as the rotating parts have a much better chance to align once in motion. In this close-up, we can see neutral, and now shifting into forward. And finally shifting back into reverse. Slow motion video reveals a lot of vibration caused by loose tolerances. The loose fitting is essential with an all 3D printed drivetrain rotating at high speed. If it were much tighter, the plastic would melt and friction weld together. I'm hoping that once in the water, the plastic will be cooled down by the fluid and not even get hot enough to fuse. Shifting seems to happen quickly and smoothly enough. The whole setup is a little rough, but it looks like it's going to work out fine. The boat is ready for its maiden voyage. After starting the motor up in neutral, the shift into forward gear happens smoothly and the craft starts to troll around. Transitioning from forward to reverse happens smoothly and quickly as well. Once in neutral, revving the motor causes the boat to shift around just from the motion of the gears in the drivetrain. In reverse, the boat does not control very well. It rotates strongly to one side and doesn't have much thrust, it seems. This is probably all just from a combination of improper design elements like the rudder and gearbox profile. Here are a few open throttle tests, and it would appear the drivetrain is robust enough to handle the power. Shifting back and forth also seems to be robust enough to keep things working, and there were no mechanical failures during this test. Overall, this design seems to be functional. It's pretty rough and needs a lot more refinement, but it works well enough for a first try.